How do I view student access data? I'm going to watch this episode of 5 Minutes of Canvas. My name is Greg Beyer, and I have been teaching with technology since the days of HyperCard. I love to make videos on how to use technology to support student learning, and have been doing so for most of my career, which has been spent mostly with Cassandra Server College and the online network of educators. I'm glad you're here and would love for you to subscribe to my channel. When students access Canvas and where they go once inside can be very useful to us, especially by pointing out which pages and activities they view over and over. But there are some limitations in the data that Canvas presents us. In this video, I will show how we can view student access data in Canvas, discuss those limitations, and end with a bonus tip on how we can download all that data into one file for offline analysis. It's demo time! The People page lists total activity time for each student, which gives us an approximation of how long each student has been navigating the pages inside our courses. Last activity is the most recent time they checked on a link or completed an action using a browser. To see when a student last accessed each item in a course, select the student's name. On the context card that appears, select their name again. This opens that student's user page. Then select the Access Report button. Sorted by the date last viewed, this table shows how many times this student accessed each item in the course, the last time they accessed it, and how many times they participated. Participation means submitting an assignment, taking a quiz, or applying to a discussion. It does not count participating in any external tools, including taking a quiz or posting a comment on a Canvas Studio video. Check the third-party tool to see what kind of student activity is documented. By the way, Canvas Studio does record the date and time for each comment and quiz attempt. Note that there is an Interactions Report button on the student's user page. It may be labeled Student Interactions Report. This goes to a table that shows when we last interacted with the student. That means a comment on a submission or a message. It does not show when they last interacted with a course. There is a class-wide student interactions report linked from the Atkins menu on the People page. I just remembered that interactions with third-party tools are not counted on this page nor in the student access report. That prompts me to talk about the value of these data, and for that, I'm going to turn to Camera 2. Hello, Camera 2. Assessing learning with access data, especially the amount of time students have spent in a class, is not a good idea. A student's click on a link to a content page means neither that they consumed the content on that page nor that they understood it. As for the amount of time spent in the class, that measures when Canvas was open to that class in a browser. A student or teacher could log into Canvas, open a course page, and then get distracted by something on their computer or device or in their real environment. The Access Report also does not effectively include activity from mobile devices, which manage that data differently than desktop or laptop computers. The best way to know that student time in a course is meaningful is to have them participate in course activities and complete assessments of their learning. But don't worry about students using mobile devices. Discussion replies composed using a mobile device can be seen by everyone, and assignments submitted via a mobile device do appear in the SpeedGrader. While we can't change how mobile devices report access data, we can prepare our courses to support learning via a mobile device. But that's not the focus of this video. Let's get back to Camera 1. While the student access data are imperfect, they can still show us which parts of our course are particularly important. However, having to access that data one student at a time is a pain. Fortunately, there's a power user in the Instructure community who has created a user script to allow us to look at all that data at one time. His name is James Jones, and he has shared many contributions. This is the page that has the Access Report script, and there's a link to this in the doobly-doo. Here are the steps. First, install the TamperMonkey User Script Manager. Then select the link to install the Access Report Data user script. Finally, go back to the People page, refresh, and a new link will be added to the Atkins menu, Access Report Data. Select this, and it will create and download a CSV file. Open this file in Excel or Google Sheets to see the data from the Access Report for all students in the same file. Now it's possible to analyze these data on Canvas Access for your entire community of learners. Thank you for watching this video. Please comment below. What role do you think that student access data should play in course design? Also, I would love to know what topics you would like explained in just 5 minutes. Never stop learning, and I'll see you in the next one.